Hello, codeLupo here. This will be the replay that took me into the leaderboard, but just don't make the mistake that I'm any good, you know? I'm just like rubbish. But yeah, enjoy the game. They have Arclight and Steel Balls, so we get some marksmen to help destroy them. Sledges will be enough for chaff clear. Vertical sledges here, so that they don't get locked on by Steel Balls. I think in the position that I'll be putting them in, my marksmen are susceptible to missiles. Also, if he has chaff in the middle, it is likely that my marksmen will be attacking those chaffs instead of Steel Balls. And my sledgehammers will be focusing on the chaff on the outside. Fight! Part. The mechs have been unleashed from both sides. They are rolling in or walking in towards the center, where they will face their mighty enemy, where they will get to taste the metal and see the explosions of the enemy. Crawlers start to engage, but actually are they? Because acolytes are destroying them from both sides. Crawlers are starting to come in from the blue side towards us from the center. The acolytes still destroy them as well. Now the juiceless chap is gone. Steel Balls and sledgehammers engage, but marksman support is just too good, and Steel Balls go down way too fast. Now just the arc lights, and the victory goes to the blue side. I have the dough, they have the goods, and I'm a willing buyer, as I will want quite a few techs later on, so I'm happy to take the tech specialist here. We're always looking to go Arclight and Marksman, and it looks like we can do so in this game. So I end up getting more chaff clear with Arclights. I get three of them. I am positioning that left Arclight slightly backwards because I don't want the Steel Boss to be focused on it. The Vide Down will go down very similar to the previous round, as not much has changed in terms of the composition of units. They go Mustangs, which helps with to clear my chaff a bit, but they have no chance. I guess my arc lights won't get a vision of them. Steel Boss still go down just as easily as before. Look at those Mustangs going down so easily. Easy squeezy. I have been working on some profitable side gigs, so I have the money to spend. Nonetheless, it probably wasn't the best idea to be spending on charged ammo, as currently there is no prime target for it. Chaff clear feels decent, so I'm getting few more marksmen. Just like with Arclight, I am positioning further back as I don't want to draw the attention from the Steel Balls. Also another marksman on the right and the Rhino. Me just positioning slightly back, don't want to be focused in on by the Steel Balls. That big boy himself, Rhino, is helping us here, walking like he knows his business, like he will be bring down unjustified pain to the enemy, like he will be cutting them down in half with his chainsaws, which is very super cool. Let's look at that Arclight go down. I'm looking really good spot here, was already winning, and now that I have level 2 Rhino, unbeatable. But as you could tell, our Steel Balls are quite good against Rhinos though. I felt like they could have not dealt with my level 2 Rhino. I could also be thrifting off these sledgehammers. I mean, they are helping with chaff clear, but like, do you really need them when you're surrounded by these many Arclights? Like, seriously. Answer me, sledgehammers, answer me. Do I really need you? Look at these Arclights doing the job that you're doing, but much better. And you're not even tanking anything. I get fire here. It's gonna be quite good against all the Mustangs and the crawlers. Also, they can't really protect against it because they're moving onto our side of playing field. We're winning. We're doing good. More of the same. Arclight. We also get range upgrade so they can clear chaff more efficiently. Putting down the fire. They will be burning. They will feel the pain. Not just the Arclight, but all of them. And here comes the pain. The fire is doing good work, but I did not realize that they only had two packs of crawlers, so it had made more sense to get charge shot on my arc lights, as they are mostly targeting steel balls. Also, enemy has no range, so it's like they're just boasting to the enemy Mustangs, like, ha ha ha, we have extra range and you don't, and you don't even need it, hee hee hee, ha ha ha. We don't need any cards here. We level the units, we get some range on the marksmen, so they're not left behind. I get Mustangs here preemptively in case he had wasps, though they am healthy and could have risked of not getting it, or just get fangs. Like they could be additional chaff and they would potentially help slightly with the wasps. Also, I do get defense here and just drop the item as I don't think I will ever use it. Opponents continue to get more of the same. You also seem to have gotten some storm callers. They really want to wreck us. Look at those barrage coming down, destroying or doing pain to my sledgehammers. So I'm paying for not getting charge shot. These steel balls are living for way too long. Would not be acceptable. But also, like, why am I so greedy? Just sell those more bars. They're just tickling the enemy, aka sledgehammers. They have free money just sitting there. They have decent mileage and big profit. What kind of rainy day am I waiting for? We end up losing here for our mistake. Gosh, cat, how could you? I guess shield drop here, shield airdrop here. It's generally cost efficient, though not really that good against steel balls. We level all our units. We finally get charge shot on our arc lights. If we got charge shot earlier instead of range, we could be getting elite marksman a few turns later for additional value, as arc lights will be leveled. Instead, we have ranged and charged shot. Some additional fangs. Oh, look at here. The cat must have been on a fish diet, as it only has 5-second memory now, failing to answer the storm callers, allowing the storm callers to continue rain pain on my units. Thankfully, the arc lights are saving my hide. The charged shot doing work, like very good work. Finally, a decent decision coming from the cat. I almost thought it was 100% pure luck. It's coming from this cat. But I guess it's around 95% luck. Besides previous round though, I was doing quite well. Picking up three of those last few storm callers. Lightning Storm is quite good for us. The enemy units will not be covered by the barrier, at least not the whole time, and it can wreck their Mustangs and steel balls. Barrier to protect ourselves, anti-air missiles to finally answer the storm callers, and we get some chaff. Also, we do some nice thrifting, selling the Rhino as it was easily getting destroyed by the steel balls. More arc lights, chaff, and range. So we can kill them quicker. Round 7. Will codeLupo come out victorious here? Lightning Storm coming out from both players though. Only the red is getting damaged here. Few phoenixes also coming in from the red. The opponent must have lost all hope. Lupo's, take down Lupo's bubbles, but it's too late. A few Mustangs are left for the red, that they will be easily cleaned up by the Arclights. So basically all Arclights are still alive, which was still coming from Stormcallers, but that won't last much longer either. Finally, a nice victory, a very nice victory. GG. This is a glorious victory for us here, getting on that leaderboard finally. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you, have a wonderful day, stay awesome, stay safe. And forever after, the cat never stopped telling stories to every single living being of how it was once on the leaderboard. For a brief second, the cat was in bliss.